Hi everyone, hope you're doing well and staying safe. Today we have with us an actress who has portrayed the role of a college diva in Mile Jab Hum Tum, as well as the famous character of Tia Kapoor in Ishq Baaz. It is none other than Naveena Bhole.
Hi.
My name is Pranay Prem and I'm from Mysa Magazine. We are glad to have you.
Hi, Pranay.
Yeah, hi, Pranay. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Pleasure's all mine.
Yeah. Okay. So, we are all familiar with your works on television, but tell us a little bit about your childhood and growing up in Mumbai.
I'm a typical Bandra baby, so I've been born and brought up in Bandra. My heart is in Bandra, even though I stay in Andheri now. And of course, anybody who stays in Bandra will tell you that, you know, once a Bandraite, always a Bandraite. And I grew up in a very full house. So we stayed in a joint family where we had my buas and, you know, my grandmother, and all of us were very pampered. It was me and my brother. And I was the good child. My brother was the brat. And I really was. I was a very good girl. Like, you could leave me alone with a book and chips and I wouldn't bother anybody. So it was that. And I grew up very studious. I grew up very fond of dancing. I grew up very fond of the arts. But I was a really fat child. Like, I was the fattest child in school. So, you know, I couldn't really dance and get very active. So then when I got into college is when I got really conscious and I said, okay, I should lose weight and I should look good. And I still didn't think that acting was anyway on the, you know, anvil. But somehow things clicked and I got to be in front of the camera. And I've, of course, never regretted it. So yeah, childhood has been lovely. Yeah. I had the best friends, the best memories. I was in an all-girls convent school, very strict. And so, yeah, I was quite a normal child, a very shy child. We didn't know about boys till we were about in the 9th or 10th standard, which is so what is not happening right now. So, yeah, that is how it was like in a nutshell. It was good.
So let's move on. Growing up as a teenager, did you already have an interest in acting or modeling, or did you have some other interest?
Okay, I'm going to tell you something which I've like never shared with anybody because it's so silly and so cheesy. So when I was like 10 and 11, you know, I would see these songs and then I would imagine myself as the heroine, like, you know, running around trees and every. So every time I would hear a song, I would, in my head, it would be me, you know, just being on that song and acting. So I knew I wanted to be in front of the camera. And but I was very shy. I still am, you know, I keep oscillating between being an introvert and an extrovert. So I get into that shell sometimes. But yeah, I wanted to do this, but my dad was also in this industry. He was associate director with Mr. Raj Khosla, and then he was directing shows for Sagar Films. So he was very clear that I don't want my daughter to be part of the industry. So, you know, I thought it was a no, but then I pursued it and I told him, I said, Dad, I would never do anything to embarrass you ever. So, you know, maybe you should let me give it a try. So then I got my folio made. I landed up, you know, being finalized for the very first audition that I went for. It was for an ad for Pakistan called Bharat Telecom. And there was no looking back since then. So that is how it all started.
So Mysa has got some exclusive content regarding
that. Yeah, it's very cheesy. You're very free to get it out of this edit if you want to. But yeah, that is how it was, you know. So I think I always wanted to do this.
Okay.
So yeah.
So from studying commerce to becoming a television actress, tell us a little about how you made your debut into the entertainment industry.
Okay, actually my very first show, a lot of people don't know this also, it was a show called Sola Singar, where it was on Sahara TV and it was opposite Karan Singh Grover. It was a love triangle, and I shot for that for about 3 months. So I played this NRI who's returned from somewhere. That was my first show. And I got it after I started circulating my pictures and started giving auditions. And then I met this lovely talent coordinator called Rupesh. And, you know, he made sure that I got a lot of work. A lot of my shows, I give him absolute credit for. So that is how I got my first show. But then I took a really long break and focused more on modeling because I was part of GladRags 2006. And I was in the top five and I was Miss Elegance. So I did a lot of modeling work. And I did a video called Dunya Haseeno Ka Mela. So the EP was the same guy who was on Milage of Humtum. So when they thought that they wanted a very glamorous diva of the college, he thought of me and he contacted me. And of course, I was more than happy to be on board. And that is how it all started. So yeah, that is how I landed. Like my first legit show was Milage of Humtum.
Well, no one can forget Diya Bhushan from Milage of Humtum.
That's a huge compliment. And yeah, she's my favorite as well. You know, I love the way she had all that attitude. And then she went from negative to gray to super positive and, you know, super supportive. So there were a lot of shades to Diya as well. I love the way she was dressed up. You know, Shivani Shirali, our stylist, has been amazing. She's been on Ishqbaaz as well. So, you know, you work with the same team because talent, you know, in this industry, it keeps getting recognized and, you know, they keep repeating people who are good at what they do. So, yeah, it's been a beautiful experience. Yeah, Diya was, Diya is immemorable to me. And I remember, I have to tell you something very interesting about this. The first, you know, this where I shot my introductory scene, it was at Sophia College. And I had to drive this really high-end car. So, it was a left-hand drive, right? So, I was very uncomfortable. And I'm supposed to drive between these crowds of people in a very narrow lane. And I ended up, you know, ramming the car and the production guy was freaking out. He was like, oh my God, you know, this is a lot of money. And, you know, so I was quite traumatized, but it just turned out okay in the end. They were like, fine, we'll manage it. But that was how my introduction scene was shot with me ramming a very, very high-end car for the production. It was a good thing they decided to still pay me and, you know, continue with me after that also. That was a different story. But yeah, you just took me back to the days of Village of Humtum.
Again, we got some exclusive content.
Yes. This is also another story which nobody really knows. You're good at this question thing. You're getting me to like open up and go back in time and, you know, talk about it. So that's a good thing.
Thank you. So you're a prominent face in the television industry. So any plans of stepping into OTT platforms?
I would love to, actually. I actually, the only content nowadays that everybody watches is OTT because, you know, there is some seriously brilliant stuff. You know, I've seen Delhi Crime recently. I've seen Hostages. I have seen Tandav. It's a couple of shows that I have watched. And I think I would love to be part. Like I told you, in the 80s, in the 90s, I used to visualize myself there. Now I visualize myself in these OTT shows and I keep thinking, oh, I would do this pretty well. Or oh, this would fit me so well. So I'd love to do it. I do have certain reservations when it comes to like intimate scenes and probably overexposing myself. But if something strong and amazing comes along, I'd definitely be willing to give it a shot.
So all the best for your OTT platform career.
Thank you. I hope I do land up with something good. I hope this is like a sign and, you know, that I'll call you up and I'll thank you if I do get an OTT show, something that I really want to do.
Definitely. So, in an era of social media and its craze, what's your take right. on it? Is it a good thing or is it a bad?
I think it's a double-edged sword. So I have to tell you, firstly, my husband has gone off social media. He closed his Facebook, he closed his Instagram. He thought that it was too toxic. It was taking away too much of his time, you know. And he said, I don't want to see what's going on with people. And I feel so good. So that's been 3 months. And he's like, oh, I feel so much at peace. And I can't even imagine doing that, you know, like not being on Instagram and not being on Facebook. So yeah, a lot of people think it's a little over. I think there's a little over information. You know, all these stars and celebrities are so much more accessible. We know what's going on with their lives, and somehow they, I think they're losing that little magic and that little aura because, you know, everybody knows what everybody is doing. You're going for a run, you're doing 5 squats, and you know, it's on your Instagram story and all of that. So wo exclusivity thoda sa, I think, jari hai. But I think it's amazing as well, because so many people who are not very known are getting exposure. If you're good, people are noticing it. There are so many social media stars. There are these TikTok stars who are doing so well. So I think it is more good than bad. And people like me who don't like really open up in person sometimes, I think on Instagram, they're so much more bolder. You know, I go and make the Don't Rush challenge and you do things and, you know, in front of the, yeah, so you do things in front of the camera. And it's fun. So I think it's a good thing. Also, I think because of social media, there's a lot more awareness. There are a lot of relevant topics that are getting a lot of mileage now, because, you know, you make a noise about it on social media and then it gets addressed and resolved sometimes. So, like I said, it's a double-edged sword, but I think overall, I think it's a good thing. And I just feel that people shouldn't misuse it, because, you know, it's the bad things also can be a lot of trolling. And a lot of bad comments and a lot of negativity. So you need to understand that you've got to be kind. I think being kind is the buzzword. So as long as you're being kind and using social media, I don't think there's any harm.
Okay, sure. So then, lastly, Mysa Magazine's ambition is to provide a platform for underrated Indian artists of all kinds to showcase their talent. What is your advice for those waiting for that opportunity to success and stardom?
I would just tell people to be themselves. It is so important to just be yourself. Don't try to be anybody else. Don't try to be what other people want you to be or what other people want to see. Just be yourself. You know, make sure that whatever you do has your essence in it. Do it with authenticity. Do it with your heart. Do it with your soul. And I think if you're doing all of that, sooner or later, your talent will be recognized and you will get the platform that you deserve. But the important thing is to keep working at it. You know, you can't not work at it. You can't wait for it to happen. You need to make it happen, is what I would say. So,
those are very kind and inspiring words.
Thank you. I am kind, actually. That is one of the things I think I am. I don't know about other things, but I try to be kind, because, you know, I whenever someone is kind to me, it just makes me feel so good about being alive that I try and be kind myself, because that's one thing which is lacking nowadays. So when you get a little bit of it, you just like hold on to it and you grab it. So I'm trying to spread the word of being kind. You should be kind.
Okay. So, thank you for such a wonderful interview. It was fun-filled and entertainment to the core. Especially, we got some exclusive content.
Okay. I hope that you mean what you're saying. But yeah, I had a lot of fun as well. I think the wait was worth it. So it was good fun.
Exactly. So thank you, ma'am. And hope to see you once again. Bye.
Thank you, Pranay. All the best. Bye.
Bye. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.